Good morning, YouTube, and welcome back to the woods. Well, they have arrived. The loggers are here this morning and they're getting at it. They've already brought down a number of trees and are taking the tops off, limbing them, and skidding them out of the woods and into the landing area, which is up by the road. You'll get to see that in a few minutes. The OG and I just arrived, and we're gonna gather ourselves up and hop in the gator and run out there and see what they're up to and do our very best to stay out of the way. So let's get at it. That John Deere makes my John Deere look small by a lot.
Destination. This rougher log's a different destination. You may cut that up small pieces of lumber.
I saw one real close to, what is that piece called? A loader?
Knuckle boom.
Knuckle boom. So I saw one real close to the knuckle boom, and it had to have been 36 inches across or more.
Thank you.
Here's my forester. This is Jeff. We're talking about what's going on here. Right now, the boss is sorting trees as they come up and cutting them down into sections. And then each pile is going to a different location. These trees are at least 75 to 80 feet long. There were a couple that were huge.
They'll probably be coming with another dragon.
Yeah. Johnny's over there cutting up. Morning. Afternoon.
Yeah.
This is the boss. This is John.
No
amazing how fast you filled it up, and
soon
we
as
thought
I
it
backed
was
this in there. I thought we're gonna have problems.
Yeah, that's kind of, I was surprised that it was like all filled up.
Do we need to clean out some of this?
No, I'm gonna try to save everything I can. I did take out the autumn olives and stuff.
Thank you. These guys got a lot going on. They have already, as you see, pulled down 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, a dozen, more than a dozen logs, dozen trees. What they'll do is they'll take these long poles, cut them down to size that a truck can run them. That's the boss. He's gonna pick this log up, and I think he's gonna put it right where I don't need to be. guys gonna set it down in that rack right there, and they're gonna measure it off, and that's where they'll cut it, and then that'll be prepped for. So now he'll pick up this one right here and put it in a pile. These poles are pulled out of the woods almost fully intact, and then they're able to use this machine to set it up on this cutter, and they'll cut it to the size that they want. See how very careful he's being or where he puts that. Needs a little help. There it goes. And then he picks that one up. That pole he has in the air is going to be every bit of 2,000 pounds easy. Maybe more, because it's wet, freshly cut wood. I can't be 100% sure, but it looks like maple. So it's heavy. And that machine has no problem picking that up. You can see the man glitter flying in the air. We're gonna cut that knot off. Now he's gonna cut this one in up to size too. So that piece right there is easily 20 feet in length. And I'm telling you, it's 5,000 pounds, 6,000 pounds or more. One of my other friends will correct me on that. Yeti 462, he knows this kind of stuff. Operator has to help it along a little bit because it's not straight. If that pole was exactly straight, that saw would go right through it. But because it's bent, what it does is the far end pinches and stops the saw. And the saw's got a clutch in it. And it will it'll not burn itself up doing that. So he's gonna make a little change there, deal with that later. And that is how they prepare the poles to be loaded on the semi-truck.
Yeah.